Hello everyone, welcome to the class. So in today's session we will be doing question number 5 from exercise 3.3 of chapter number 3, data handling from NCERT book. Okay, so question number 5 states that consider this data. So you have, these are the data which is given in the book only, your book you can verify. Consider this data collected from a survey of a colony. So from a colony this survey was done, and favorite sport, how much they watch and how much they are participating, that was taken a survey, data was taken out. So what are the favorite game sports mentioned out there is cricket, basketball, swimming, hockey and athletics. So these were the game, these were the sports which was mentioned, and out of this cricket watched was 1240, basketball was 470, swimming 510 people were watching, and hockey 430 and athletic 225. These were the list of watching these sports. Now how many of them are actually participating? 620, 320, 320, 250, 105. So compared to the watching, participants are very very less, right? So we Indian are very much fond of cricket, you all know that. So it is 1240. We all like to watch, right, cricket with our family, friends, right? So now using this data, what you have to do is you have to draw a double bar graph, which we have done previously also in our previous class. Now draw a double bar graph choosing an appropriate scale. Okay, we have to choose a scale here. So you can see the measurement here. From 0 to 100 there is certain measurement, right? So one unit I have taken how much, 100 distance, that is 100 people. So with that scale I will be doing the double bar graph here. So what do you infer from the graph that we have to mention? First of all, let's make a bar graph, double bar graph. So number of the people who are watching cricket is 1240. So the one who is watching, I'm representing over here with the green one. So I'm making green box here. So I'm making a green box. I have already told you whatever you are representing should be written here with the different color, different sketch pen, different pencil you can use, or you can make the pattern also. Alright, the pattern should be followed. So green one will be representing the watching, T-C-H-I-N-G, watching, and let me choose the the blue one, let me choose red one. Red one will be for the participating one. So double bar graph, as you people only mentioning that you people have done since when you are in class 4, right? So this must not be very hard for you all, I think. So just look at the data, okay, and plot it. Watching 1240, so 1240 must lie somewhere here. So if this is suppose 1250, then it should be below this. So I'll take this as a 1250. So this will be my 1240. So the number of the people who are watching actually cricket is 1240. So this is 1240. Now next, participating, who are actually participating should be marked with a red. So it should be 620. So 620 lies in between 700 and 600. So 620 must lie over here, somewhere here. Okay, let me zoom this. So 620 somewhere like over here. So I am giving a mark over here. So this is my double bar graph. The number of the people who are watching is 1240. The number of the people who are actually participating is 620. Okay. So here, let me make a one mark here with the black. And let me write what is this sports actually representing. This is actually representing for cricket, as you know, right? Cricket. Okay, so I hope this is understandable. In x-axis sports are represented, so it has been mentioned the game, that is sports, is cricket. Okay, next type of sports we have is basketball. Among all the people, 470 people are actually watching the basketball. So where is 470 lying? So and watching is actually represented with green. Don't forget to do that. 470 lies somewhere here. Okay. so lies somewhere here. So I'm marking over here like this. So let me make this little bit thicker. So this is actually 470 people watching the basketball. Now how many are actually participating? Only 320. So participant should be marked with the red one. So it is 320. 320 lies somewhere here. So I'm marking over here. So this is 320, which is actually representing for the sports basketball. Okay, let me write the basketball here. So this much. So I hope you have understood this. And next game we have is swimming, right? So swimming, first you will be writing with the green, making with the green, whoever are watching, 510. So 510 somewhere lies over here. So I'll be making here, it is 517. So this is actually representing 510 for swimming who are watching. Next, we will be marking with the red one, whoever are participating, 320. So both the values are same, so I can use the same value, that is 320 for participating. Now, which game is actually representing this? This is actually represented by swimming. So let me write here swimming. So this should be done in this beautiful manner, in the slow, in very slowly, calmly. Do not get hurry, do not draw with the help of your hand. Use your scale and pencil. Next we have is hockey. Hockey for watching, it should be marked with green. Hockey 430. So 430 lies somewhere here, I think. Yes, so 430, let me mark it over here. Okay, 430 and 470 are looking same. So let me mark little bit here. Okay, so this will be representing 430, and 250 people are actually participating in hockey. So where is 250? 250 should be at the center. So at the center, let me make this at the center. So okay, over here, 250. All right, very easy thing, right? Just now mark which game you are representing. Hockey, hockey, hockey. Okay, then the next one, the last one which we have here, is the game called athletic, which who actually wants to watch, who likes to watch, are 250. So 250, in this one only we have done it, so I will take the help of that. 250 is this. And the one who are participating is only 105. So 105 will be marked with the red one. So 105 should be over here. Sorry, that is 150. 105 should be somewhere here, below that only. So let me mark it over here. So this is 100 actually. So 100, then 105 should be somewhere here like this. If you calculate the value, you'll get it properly. So for which game it is actually representing? It is representing for athletic. So in this manner, student, I hope you have understood this. In this manner, we have to fill the bar graph, okay, in your graph copy. Now, using this double bar graph, you have to infer something about this bar graph. What do you infer? What do you get? What knowledge you get from this bar graph? So we get a conclusion from this. We get a knowledge that we will write that in number one. This is the number one answer only. Draw a double bar graph we have made. Now what is the infer? What do you infer from this bar graph? Infer means what knowledge you get from this bar graph. So looking at the bar graph, we can easily say that, looking at this graph, we can easily say that the graph is actually representing double bar graph. So let us write the graph. The bar graph is representing representing double bar graph, right? Is representing double bar graph. And in this graph, what is actually thing? What is the actual thing? In from this bar graph, the graph is representing, or the graph represents number of people watching and participating the sports. Yes, you get the knowledge of that only. What are the number of the people who are watching, who are participating? Yes, in different sports. Not only that, we also come to know that from this graph, looking at this graph, we also come to know that most people like to watch and participate in cricket. Yes, so we can write, most people like to watch and participate in sport, in cricket. Yes, looking at this bar graph, you can easily say that in cricket everyone is interested, watching also and in participating only also. And least people like to play and participate in athletics. Yes, yes or no? You can easily say that the least people are liking to watch and participate in athletics. So we came to conclusion of this, looking at this double bar graph, looking at this data, right? So I hope you people have understood this. We are over with question number one now. Number two, which sport is most popular? I have already told which is the most popular. So among all the sports mentioned, cricket is the most popular sport. Most popular sports. I have already told what conclusion we got. Looking at this double bar graph, we came to conclusion that cricket is the most familiar or the popular game. Now one more question is left out. That is question number three. Which is more preferred, watching or participating in sports? Okay. So which is most preferred one? That you have to do it yourself. This will be a home assignment. All right, children. So I hope you will do it. I hope you will be able to do, as because in the double bar graph, looking at this double bar graph, you can easily say what is the answer. All right. So this much for today. In our next class, we will proceed with the next sum. Till then, stay safe and healthy. Thank you, everyone.